Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn a concept that is conservation of momentum. So first of all, we have to learn what is a momentum. Momentum is nothing but when you apply external force on the object, where the object is at rest, then the object starts moving. Now the object attains some amount of velocity. Okay? Now the momentum can be defined as the product of mass of the object and its velocity of the object. Now we go for that. So first of all, we have to consider two objects, object A and object B. This is object A, and A's mass is MA, and object B, and its mass is MB. They both are traveling along a straight line. If they are in motion, definitely they have velocities. Now the velocity of the first object is UA, and the velocity of the second object is UB. We can say them as initial velocities of the objects A and B. Now we can consider this situation as before collision. We can consider the situation as before collision. Before collision, the two objects are traveling along a straight line, having the initial velocities UA, UB, with the different masses MA and MB of the objects A and B. Now, if you take at the time of collision exactly, this is object A and this is object B. What is the situation at the time of collision exactly? Now if you take the first object A, is applying certain force on the object B. Okay, so in this particular direction, now the force is applied from A on the object B is FAB. At the same time, equal and opposite force is also applied by B on the object A. The force is applied by the object B on the object A. If you see that they are traveling in opposite directions and they are having different directions, so you can see at the time of collision. After the collision, the two objects attain different velocities and having the same masses MA in case of A and MB in case of B, but the velocities are VA in case of the object A and VB in case of object B. So this is the situation after collision. This is after collision. So if you observe that before collision and after collision, there are some changes in their velocities, and so we can directly say that definitely there is a change in its momentum. Okay, then we go for the momentum. So the rate of change of momentum of an object A is equals to rate of change of momentum of an object A is equals to, as we know that momentum is nothing but the product of mass and velocity, right? So here the new term is rate. Rate is nothing but comparing the time, right? So mass of the object A into the velocity of the object A before collision and after collision, you have to take the difference. Now it is BA minus UA with respect to time. In this case, BA is greater than UA, for example. And you can say rate of change of momentum of an object A is nothing but, right, the force which is applied by the object A on the object B. As we know that FAB, then we can just as FAB is equals to MA into BA minus UA divided by 2. Let it be equation number 1. Now, in case of B, rate of change of momentum of an object B, which is equals to C, so mass of the object and velocity of the object. So mass of the object B is mb into, again we have two velocities before collision and after collision. We have to change, we have to take the change, we have to take the difference in between them, that is vb minus ub. As you know that vb is greater than ub, and with respect to time divided by t. So you know the rate of change of momentum of an object B is nothing but the force which is applied by the object B on the object A. So we can replace as FBA, which is equals to MB into VB minus UB divided by T. Let it be equation number 2. Let it be equation number 2. Right. Now, according to Newton's third law of motion, so when there is action, definitely there is an equal and opposite reaction. Got it? So, for example, at the time of collision, how much force the object A is applied? Equal amount of force can be applied by the B, but you take the directions to go the opposite. Right? So, according to Newton's third law of motion, when there is action, definitely there is an equal and opposite reaction. So therefore, FAB is an action and it is traveling in normal direction. If you consider it as a normal direction, definitely this is opposite to that. So they both are equal, but negative sign indicates they are traveling opposite to each other. Right. So if you substitute these values from equation number 1 and 2, so we will get the equation as MA into VA minus UA divided by T, which is equals to minus of MB into VB minus UB divided by T. So in this equation, T as a common term, you can cancel it. And after that, MA into VA minus UA, which is equals to minus of MB into VB minus UB. Now I am going to multiply MA with BA and UA. MA into UBA, that is MA into BA plus of minus MA into UA, which is equals to minus as it is. Start writing. MB into BB. MB into BB. So minus of plus minus. MB into UB. MB into UB. So now MA BA minus MA UA, which is equals to, I'm going to apply minus 2 to these two terms. Now minus of plus minus MB BB. Now minus of minus plus MB UB. Now we are going to write the U terms aside, V terms other side. So here it is MA VA. So here it is minus term, right? If it transfers to right side, so it becomes plus. Here it is a minus term in the right side. If it comes to left side, it becomes plus. MB B, which is equals to MA UA plus MB UB. I'm going to rewrite the equation. Therefore, MA UA plus MB UB, which is equals to MA BA plus MB BB. If you see this equation, MA UA, it is a momentum of the object before collision. If you observe this, it is also the momentum of the object B before collision and plus summation. Now this is the total momentum of the object A and B before collision. If you observe this, MADA, momentum of the object after the collision, object A, MBUD, momentum of the object B after collision, summation. So this will give you the total momentum of the object A and B after collision. So right, equals to that. Okay? So before collision, the total momentum of the object A and B before collision, which is equals to, so the total momentum of the object A and B after collision. So both are equals. Before collision and after collision, the total momentum of the object A and B are equal, remains unchanged, no change in it. This is called as law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. Got it? Right. So if you take the momentum before collision and after collision, you cannot find anything in that. You cannot find any change in that. Okay? That is called law of conservation of momentum. Okay? I hope you understood the topic. Thank you very much.